Hey everyone, this is FireworksTutorial. In this video I'm going to show you how to make your own custom background. Now, if you have a background like this, I'm going to show you how to make it more colorful, more prettier, I guess, and turn it into something similar to this. Now, this is not the best background out there, but it's decent. So, I'm going to show you how to make this. It's better than nothing, really. And so, let's get started. Okay, the first thing is I would recommend you get Firefox if you don't have Firefox. And you need to download something called ScreenGrab. It's a free add-on at the Mozilla website, which the link will be in the description. So, pretty much, you don't have to do anything except install it and you're all set. And if you don't want Firefox, I'm not sure how that's gonna work, but I guess you can find some way to capture your screen. I'm not sure how, but that's all on you. And I guess you can use the print screen button on your keyboard. Okay, so I'm gonna use ScreenGrab because it's much easier. And I'm gonna save this on my desktop. Once you're done, I'm going to use Fireworks, Adobe Fireworks for this one. You can use Gimp, you can use Photoshop, pretty much any picture editor, any decent one that allows layering. And we're just going to click and drag the photo into here. And there we go. We get our channel on Fireworks. Okay. Now, why did I do this? Actually, I captured it to pretty much show where we're supposed to put our text on a blank area. Make sure that it's not, but we don't put hi under the comments box and stuff like that. Okay. All right. Now, first of all, what we're gonna do is use the rectangle tool. And we're just gonna pull out any blank area, random area. And right here, we're just gonna go here and we're gonna look at our dimensions, which is 990 by 727. So down here, we're gonna put 990 by 727. Make sure the X and Y are both on zero. And there you go. Perfect, perfect rectangle above the channel. And what we're going to do is we're going to pull this layer down under the channel layer, I guess. This always happens to me, I don't know why. Okay, I've got it. And so just pull that back up, and what we're going to do is we're going to put all our contents the way we want. So let's make another let's make another rectangle right here. Okay, and I guess we can make it any color we want. I'm gonna make it bluish. There we go. Drag this up. And let's see, any shape. Okay, it's pointing this way only. But let's make one anyways. And we're going to use this tool, the scale tool, and we're just going to point it up. Okay. Doesn't have to be perfect since it's just a test. Point it up. Make it smaller, I guess. And text will be comments. Let's make that white and a bit smaller. Doesn't have it to be perfect, just make it look a bit good. Whoops. Okay, a good idea is to lock your contents once, if you begin making it, just lock it so it won't be moved anywhere. You see, I can't move the box anymore because I've locked it, but I still can move the arrow and stuff. The text, I just leave it unlocked because it's not, you can still move it around easily. It doesn't have to be aligned perfectly, okay, but it's good enough. I can also use the styles on this right side actually, and yeah, and it looks pretty. The styles are nice, so I like them. And let's make another arrow. Twist it around. And I'm gonna put activities. It's just random, I guess. Okay, and just select a style. And there. Maybe I wanna cover these so they look good. These box, like color code them, I guess. But then if you put this on your channel, you won't be seeing it looking like this. It will be more like this under your comment box. Let's make that solid color green. Okay. And on this side, you want the box here. Color reddish, purplish. And recent activity. I want to make that red. Okay. And up here, usually where people put their little bars and stuff, we can just make a quick one right now. Okay. Just make a random one. And we can color it blue. Or make a blue right there. Use the blue right there so it looks 3D like. And we'll put text like, "Hi, thanks for checking out my channel." Let's put this in smaller font. Just pull this out. Okay, and we'll put this in the middle, I guess. Okay, and pretty much we're all done. And all we need to do is we're gonna delete this YouTube thing. So we just delete that. But then the trash can, and this is what our final project looks like. Shouldn't have moved that, but okay. And we're just gonna save this. I guess that is not perfect because it's just a test. And we'll put YouTube BG for background. And we go and edit channel. Go to channel design. And right here, background image, just browse. And here is where it is. Oh, okay, forgot. Make sure to save this as a JPEG image because that will put it in smaller file size. Save that. Because PNG is just kind of too much. The file size is too large. And once we're done, we click update channel. And let's take a look at our channel. And yeah, it looks pretty decent for a few minutes thing. And this is kind of over the top a bit. To color code it, maybe you want to upload a black background first to see where the white part of this is and so on. And yeah, that's pretty much that. Hope you enjoy this video and learn something from it, and I'll see you guys next time.